Welcome back to the Witcher 3 Wild Hunt.
Rurik, right? Heard you were on a boat the drowners attacked.
Aye, I was. With Ulf, my cousin, gathering our crab traps off the Kerrig cliffs. Ulf was pulling up a line, having a hard time of it. Grand, I thought. Cage has got to be full, it'll be a good haul. Then something tugged back and down. Weren't a blink and Ulf was underwater. Called after him, once, twice, thrice. Then the water went red with blood. I smelled something horrid. Rotten, but worse. And the Muir Dieblin flipped the boat. Don't even know how I made it ashore. Must have had Freyr watching over me.
That, or the monsters had eaten their fill. Thanks for the story. Are you Tove? I was told drowners killed your husband.
Then you were told right. First the sea took me son, and now me man. I'm the only one left. Kivilla, our son, he went out fishing and didn't come back. My man would walk out to the Kierag cliffs every day to watch for his boat. I told him he cannot bring him back to life, and that he could die himself. We'd heard about drowners. But he couldn't sit still. Donned his old coat and went. One night, he didn't come home. I fetched me brother, grabbed a torch and we went looking for him. The Muir Dieblin, sea fiends. They'd clawed him so bad, I only knew him by his coat.
Small comfort, I know. But the drowner problem will soon end. I promise you that. Farewell.
Puddles. Can't be that easy, can it? Just go and kill a bunch of drowners?
Another victim.
Ah, the drowners of the Witcher world.
That stench. Drowners for sure. Lair must be nearby.
First, let's deal with the other group, then find their lair, wherever the hell it is.
Crabs. Must be near the fishing ground Rurik mentioned. Stench. Drowners for sure. Lair must be nearby. stench again. Slime and rotting flesh.
Wait, who killed it? Hold on a second.
A pelvis. Scratched up. Long white claw marks. More drowners.
Oh, awesome, a group of drowners. Oh, you know what? Have some fun with that. Burn, baby, burn.
A monster's lair, but definitely not a drowner's. Almost untouched. Hidden for later. Drowners just don't do that.
Water hags do. This is the place where Conan O'Brien actually visited when he was doing his quote-unquote review.
Bruises on his neck, crushed larynx, strangled. Bits of boats, torn sails, lines. Sailing decor, you could call it. That stench, the marks on the bodies. This must be a water hag's lair. Got a keen sense of smell. She won't come back while I'm here. Unless... she coexists with drowners. Maybe I could make an extract from their glands, cover up my scent. That should do it. Now for a place to hide and wait. Behind those boats.
Time to kill a hag, right? A bear.
Damn it.
Okay. Couple of strong attacks and it's dead.
Job's done. Here's the proof.
Now why would I want to see... What the devil's that?
Water hag. An old, clever one. She was the danger.
Seen a lot of ugly critters in me life. Morays, lampreys, blobfish. But never nothing like this. Your award. Well earned, Witcher. Well earned.
Thanks. So long.
Seen the plans? Strange long.
I think it's a reasonable enough payment. At least that's my opinion on that. Right, did I gain any good swords? Nope, I did not. None of these are really good. I probably should sell one or two of them. Okay. Your uncle wouldn't necessarily be wrong. Oh, there's probably one final DLC quest, isn't it? Likely so, yeah, probably. Anyway, I will go right here and see what I can. Come on. You know, there is someone, a woman, who you can sleep with, provided that you defeat her in a duel. I just don't know where she is. I probably should check that out one point or another. She's in some arena or something along those lines.
That's it, Roach.
Mind if I interrupt?
Nay. My prayers are in vain anyways.
Heard you're a man with troubles.
Aye, I am. Look, see it lying there. The horse head on the pole. That's...
A nithing. Kind of curse, seen this before. They're nothing to scoff at. Can bring misfortune, even death.
Aye, and the name carved upon it is Tialva. My firstborn! Boy's feverish. Grows weaker by the day. I fear I'll bury him before the next moon. Tried to lift the curse myself, but no luck.
I can help you one of two ways. First, I can try to convince whoever put up the nithing to lift the curse themselves. Second, I can deflect the curse back on whoever cast it by writing their name on the shaft. Either way, need to know who's behind this.
But I don't trouble no one. Don't know a soul who'd wish it upon me.
Mm-hmm. Guess I gotta investigate. Nithing. A powerful curse. Name carved on the shaft. Tialva, son of Lothar. Trails fresh. Might want to look around some.
Come on.
Shawl. Distinctive pattern. Distinctive smell. Too many scents. Can't follow my nose any further. Need to ask around about the shawl.
Aye, aye, hero.
Greetings.
Greetings. Fare thee. Hey there, vagrant. Aye?
Why does death yar? They light lanterns on the rocks, then loot the wrecked ships.
Aye. Taverns of water.
I'm a tad busy. You're away. Aye? What's it you need?
Any chance you know who wore this shawl?
Of course. Yona, our herbalist, lives there, in that hut. Oh, she'll be pleased you found it for her.
Yeah, real pleased.
Stay along. We Freya to thank for sending you our way.
Found your shawl, near Lothar's house, by the Nithing you put up there.
How did you know?
Had a hunch. Thanks for confirming it. You know Tjalva's got one foot in the grave?
Good. That bastard should never have been born. Me, I was to be Lothar's bride, but he cast me aside for that flounder. Getting his comeuppance now. Him and that whole ploughing family.
You'd kill a child out of jealousy? Are you serious?
It's not jealousy, but dignity that matters here. 10 years we lived side by side. 10 years I cooked for him, washed his breeches, shared me bed. And he abandoned me with nary a word. The whole village laughed. Stupid Bint Yona let herself be had. Oh no, I have not been had, nor have I forgot.
Want you to lift the curse. I mean it.
Fine, I'll do it. But I've my terms. Lothar's to renounce his son and come back to me.
I'll be sure to tell him. But I think we both know what his answer will be.
Fucking woman. Yeah, it is jealousy. Petty jealousy at that.
Best blade's not worth shite if a weak arm's swinging at eight.
Come on, Roach.
Hey there.
So, you know who placed the Nithing?
Old friend of yours, Yona.
I might have guessed. Jealous bitch! Can't stand to see others happy. So, will she lift the curse?
Yeah, sure. All you gotta do is renounce your family and go back to her.
Never! My wife, my son, I'd strip them of honor. Condemn them to poverty. You've got to break the spell, Witcher. Let her die!
Does she really deserve this? Prob. Two people for one. Damn it. Damn this decision! Fucking... There's more moral nuance here than in the main... than in most of the main story combined, with the exception of the Bloody Baron. Fucking hell. What should I do? What decision? Difficult to make. Fuck it.
You might deserve to be punished, but not this way. Fine, I'll do it.
Thanks be to the gods.
Don't bring the gods into it. This is between two human beings.
I'm a simple chap. Seek no trouble.
painless.
So? Did it work?
It did. Your son should recover soon. And Yona will die.
Thanks, Witcher. 1,000 times over. My son's dearest of all to me. I couldn't abide it if he died. Your reward. Will you eat with us before moving onward?
No. Not in the mood.
There's truth to that blather at the ice giant.
Up comes the Witcher.
Think our young bow will set off on another adventure?
Don't make me angry.
Fuck it. Damn it. What the decision, really? What the damn decision?
Can't do that. Yona doesn't deserve it.
And my son? Does he?
No, but he doesn't have to die. You have a choice.
All right. If it'll save Chalva, I'll go back to the hussy. And you, best not see your face round here again.
Faster.
See, I like it here. Need help?
Thanks, girl.
You'll forget them. I'll bear your sons, strong and healthy ones.
Sure.
You'll see.
There's
well,
truth to that
will you say anything?
The ice
leave me be, woman. I agreed to come back here. Not to love you.
You're a Witcher, right?
So.
Greetings.
Greetings.
See ya.
Fare thee well.
The giant, sure, but now you just fass about seducing the lasses.
I'm gonna stick with my original decision. Wanted to see what happens otherwise, but I can't help but feel disgusted by my choice. Regardless of what choice I make.
So.
Oh, yeah.
Nay.
You might. Don't bring the gun.
So?
It did.
Thanks. Your reward.
No. Go, go.
She's dead, so be it. And all my monster contracts are completed with that. Doesn't mean I'm fucking satisfied with how it all ended. Well, there's still stuff that I could do. Like, there's two quests right here. Yeah. Probably should do them. But anyway. Costin here on Serious Gaming, signing out.